This is Dr. David Schein, and welcome to Business Law 101. Where do you get the law? Well, there's different types of law. The preferred area to get law from is actual legislation. And so we're familiar with that. We'll talk some more about that in a minute. Judicial pronouncements. When a judge makes a decision in a case, that has a value to it. And so we tend to follow previous judicial decisions. And then procedural law. Procedural law defines how we interact with the justice system. And certainly America today is an area where we see what happens when order breaks down. I was in Portland, Oregon almost exactly 2 years ago for my annual legal teaching conference. It was a beautiful city. It was quiet and pleasant, good weather conditions, and the people seemed very calm, and it was fun to walk around and fun to do things there. And I am very saddened to see the city of Portland today after over 3 months or roughly 3 months of civil injustice and revolt and riots and so forth. And so many people are negatively affected by that. The breakdown of order affects the people's lives and the quality of their lives. So we don't need to look very far from what's happening today to see what happens if law does not help to support the community. So it's a difficult situation today. Where do we get law? Well, these rules are in order, or they're supposed to be in order. The United States Constitution is the supreme law of the land in the United States. Now, there is something else parallel to the Constitution, and that is treaties with other countries. So the Constitution and treaties with other countries are number one. Number two, legislation passed by Congress or at the state level by the states and so forth. Number three, judicial decisions. The judges make a decision about whether the laws are being properly interpreted. And then the administrative rules come in fourth. Now, one of the issues that is somewhat political today is the argument that we are over-regulated. That's in this last group, that these people who are not elected have become the bosses and make a lot of arbitrary decisions, whether they're under a Democratic administration or Republican administration. It seems that these folks are on their own little path, and the state of the United States and the state of our individual states seems to be struggling as these administrative rules continue to burden us. And one of the arguments that Trump has been successful is that Trump has supposedly reduced the amount of administrative rules since he went into office. And of course, with the exception of COVID-19, the economy seems to have gone up. So it certainly remains to be seen. I think that the administrative state has a long way to go to become more productive and help us out as business people.